Well, that leads us right into the old joke that never gets old. There are only two seasons in Minnesota, winter and road construction season. Anoka kicks it off for us over the weekend with a two-year overhaul of Highway 10. If you don't drive around those parts, you might around these parts. Highway 55, Hiawatha Avenue in Minneapolis. This one's going to be a months-long headache from downtown to Highway 62. MnDOT has not revealed a specific starting day. Cool suspense. Only saying it will begin this spring and last into the fall. Seasons are in flux, so that really could mean anything. This also happens to be Work Zone Awareness Week, and there's a new push to make drivers more aware of the danger your speeding poses to the people working on our roads.
Yeah, even before the pandemic, studies were tracking the link between increasing speeds in work zones and an increase in serious crashes. Of course, speeding grew even more in the last 2 years. A 2020 study found only about 1 in 3 drivers actually followed the posted speed limit in a work zone. MnDOT has proposed more than a dozen ideas to help try to address this, and one of them involves cameras that could catch drivers in the act with photo enforcement, like they have in other states. But that would require some work in the legislature.
It's well documented that more drivers are speeding on all types of roads since the pandemic began. But on certain stretches of road, the danger they pose to others is greater.
We had 500 deaths on our roadways last year. It's very, very dangerous for somebody to be working in a work zone. It's their office, and we need to slow people down and make sure that they return home to their families at night.
Representative Connie Bernardy says that's the driving force behind a new amendment she added to the current House transportation bill.
Full disclosure, we're talking in our cars, but we're both parked.
Exactly, being safe.
She says her amendment builds on a report from MnDOT and the Department of Public Safety that suggested that automated enforcement cameras could help reduce speeding and increase safety in work zones. She says the state patrol is open to the idea as well.
It would be a pilot to see how it works, and it would happen in 2 work zones somewhere in Minnesota. And then we'll see how it works and if we're able to save lives and prevent people from getting injured in these very, very dangerous work conditions.
But implementing even a limited plan would be complicated. Though allowed in some states, the Minnesota Supreme Court ruled years ago that automated red light cameras are unconstitutional here. That's why Representative Bernardy is asking the state agencies to take the next year to come up with a detailed implementation plan.
What would you tell people who see something like this and they're like, I don't want to be a state that has automated enforcement cameras?
On a study that I had seen, the public is very supportive of using these tools in work zone safety zones, and it is very, very limited. And I don't think anyone would argue that we want to make sure that mothers and fathers return home to their families at night, and sons and daughters too. And this is a really important measure to keep people safe.
And that's one reason why, at least for now, the amendment has bipartisan support from co-author John Petersburg.
We are all concerned about safety, and we know that this past couple years, speed has been a factor in regards to fatalities and other poor behaviors. And so I think it's important for us to not just drop the ball or stop the process.
Why give it a year if this problem is really dire right now?
Well, we need to have a good plan that will help implement this program. Having leadership in the Department of Public Safety and the Minnesota Department of Transportation take the lead and make the recommendations is a really important step in the legislature determining how they're going to move forward with a very narrow pilot on work zone safety.
Now, at least 19 states have speed enforcement cameras, but figuring out the enforcement part, even for a pilot project like this, won't be easy here. Most states rely on radar and timestamp photos to send citations to the owners of vehicles. But in 2007, our Supreme Court said that kind of approach is a problem because it presumes that owners are guilty and puts the burden on them to prove they weren't driving.